University of Tulsa on a full athletic scholarship, where he accumulated 20 sacks and multiple all-conference honors. He was named Defensive Player of the Year in 2014 and received the Ultimate Team Award in 2015. Derek is a member of this great fraternity, Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. And I like purple too myself. And enjoys volunteering of his own in his spare time, where he is mentoring every youth in the North Tulsa area. Guys, give a round of applause for our keynote speaker, Derek Alexander.
Thank you, Brother Love. How y'all doing?
All right.
Hey, here we go. One more time, how y'all doing?
All right.
Yeah, I'm going to try to keep y'all awake today. I know y'all eating, but I don't want a case of that itis. But as he said, you know, I'm born and raised in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I roam the streets of Pine and Peoria, coming down Cincinnati. I still call it Cincinnati. You know, born and raised, Ryan. I love it. I love Tulsa, and I love giving back to my community. You know, during my time here, I played at Booby T. I was an off-state player of the year there. Then went to TU, as you said, multiple all-conference offers. I mean, all-conference honors and things of that sort. And the reason why I tell you those things is not to brag, but it's because the things I'm going to tell you today are going to be an accumulation of the things that I learned throughout that process. So throughout that process, I put these things together, and not saying I've done it, I did all these processes at that time, but I just learned and grew, and now I'm giving it to you. And as we move forward, the objectives of today are, I want to make sure we learn ways to improve our quality of living. I think that's a big deal to me. It's a big deal for everybody, is improving the quality of living. And one reason why I think it's so important is because that's something we can do that doesn't necessarily need any form of monetary or financial value needed to go forward. Next, I want to make sure we emphasize, go get a screening. You know, as men, I know a lot of times we don't want to go see the doctor, or because we don't want to see or hear bad things, or just scared of the unknown. So we gotta make sure we go get that happening. And then from here, we need to implement. I want to implement three things. You know, I want to make sure when by the end of my speech, you can go and you can implement three things into your life that you can choose to grow and add value to your own life. One of those things that I want to emphasize is water. Water for me was very important. You know, just starting off, how many people in here play sports? I know I see a couple of Booty T, McLean, the Scotsman. I'm gonna do a throwback. But you know, what sports did you play? Other than football, you got somebody who played any other sports?
Basketball.
You play basketball? You good?
Yeah.
Good. But you know, just going into that, you know, I remember water's so important. You know, if you don't drink water before your practices or before your games, what usually happens?
Dehydrate.
You pull something. You cramp. You know, all those things. And that happens in a game, but we play in a game called life, and it's just as important or more important. So why not drink water? I mean, I remember, now this is not a smart story. I was coming back from Booker T. We just did a two-day practice. It was like 110 degrees. It was hot. And we came from a tour day. My quarterback used to take me home during those times. And I remember I came back home. I used to call myself being tough. I wouldn't drink water during practice. So I'd go through all practice and not drink water, because my thought process was, you know, I play all game, so why I'm not gonna get some water in the game. So I get back to the house, which, do not let your kids do that. Do not, they need water during practice. But I get back to my house and my quarterback's dropping me off, and I have my pads and stuff in the back seat. And when I go into his back seat to go get my bag and go get my stuff, all of a sudden, you know, I reach back up, bam,
right there, on that Charlie board, right there, complaining on me. So I come back, I try to stretch it out, and then before you know it just hits me, hits. And now I'm cramped up all from my lower body. Now mind you, I'm in the middle of the street. I literally fall back on the ground on the hot concrete that had to be 100 degrees. And I told my coworker, I'm like, go get my dad. A lot of y'all probably know my dad here. He was the police officer that was in here before. But I told him, go get my dad. And I'm on the ground, I'm hurting. And he comes outside. He comes outside, and I tell you, this man didn't even try to help me up. He didn't give no effort. He just looked at me, smiled, and said, get in the house. And I was in. So I had an army crawl into my house from the street into my house. But when I got in there, he helped me out. But I thought that was pretty funny. I was like, man, you can help out your son, your firstborn. But it's just stressing the importance of it. And the adult human body, well, you know, mostly where I read, your body's made up of 50 to 65% water. You know, that's a big part of our body. So we need to keep on replenishing that so that we can make sure our body is functioning naturally, smoothly. Because without those things, we're causing our body to almost fight itself because it doesn't have the proper fluid, you know? Just like kind of put oil in your car. Ways to incorporate water, you know, drink a cup before a meal. We all gonna make sure we're gonna have three meals for the most part. You know, we gonna eat at least 2 times a day sometimes. So let's make sure we throw water, you know, have a cup of water before that. Various different apps, so we're in like a whole new technology age. So you got apps like Waterlogged right here who will help you track how much water you're drinking in a day. And it kind of gives you kind of like a little bit of a competition. So if you want this, or if your goal is this much, it'll ring you, give you a ding, a message, tell you, hey, we need to get back on it. Let's get some more water in. Have more water-rich foods as far as like fruits, vegetables, spinach, you know, watermelon, oranges. All these types of things are various different ways to also get water into your system. Some of the benefits, you know, weight loss, it kind of speeds up your metabolism a little bit, especially in the morning. You know, just wake up, just drink a cup of water. Kind of gets everything kind of going. It'll have you in a better mood. Because I don't know about y'all, but sometimes when I don't drink water, I get a headache. You get a little dehydrated. And, you know, when you get a headache, you're irritable. So now you don't want to talk to people. So it'll put you in a better mood. It's also just better for your skincare, your teeth. You know, there's different research that shows that water helps in all those things. Next thing is sleep. She knocked out. She is sleep. You don't know if she is sleep or dead. But again, sleep is another thing that is pennies in the bank. It doesn't cost to drink water. You know, we all pretty much have it, you know, unless you're paying for your water, but it doesn't cost to go to bed a little bit early either. When you go to sleep early, it just helps you get in a better mood. For somebody, you know, let me just go around the room. How much sleep do you say you usually get a day or during the week?
Man, I get a lot of sleep. That's
up. Well, if you can give me a number, how much sleep would you say you get? You get up, you go to work. 10 hours? 10 hours?
Ooh.
Six? Four? Three or four?
Ooh.
Five? Okay. Well, those are the answers I was kind of expecting. You know, you go to bed, you say four, maybe five. Well, the reason I ask that is because when you do that and you kind of short yourself on your sleep also your time to recover. So if you're shorting yourself on the time to recover, I remember this just happened 2 days ago. I was in the weight room and it was a guy, he was lifting, and he was like, man, my back hurt. And I was like, okay, like, what you been doing? He's like, man, I've been stretching out my back all day. And I was like, all right, did you get any sleep last night? Because he works out every day, and it's like 6 a.m. So if you're not getting, you're going to bed at 1, waking up at 5 to try to make it to the gym at 6, and you lifting every day, your body, that's going to take a hit on your body. So now you're like, oh, those stretches don't work anymore because you're not giving yourself time to sleep. Just the mental and physical wellness. You know, when you get more sleep, when you wake up and you're more energized, you're just
a better version of yourself. You know, you're a lot easier to do, you know, talk to people, relatable. You know, I know me as far as like if I get up, I know I gotta get up at 6 a.m. I'm in bed at 12. It kind of got that fog, you know, that kind of like fog. I'm still trying to wake up. Don't really talk to me. I was trying to make things happen. But when you go to bed and you're getting your full 8 hours, you're waking up, you're kind of ready to go get the day going. It spins in the bank as far as value. I know a lot of us, you know, we come to a time in our lives, I don't know if you got into investing or just accumulating any type of value. It's just one of those things that if you keep on putting and keep on doing this action, it spins in the banks that'll help you out in the future. Next slide. Now this is the last two were kind of easy, drinking water, going to sleep early. Now I'm asking you to get out and move. We gotta get some more activities in our day. How many of y'all would say that we move less now than we did before, let's say 20 years ago? Well, yeah. Why do you think that is?
Old age?
Yeah. Technology? All right, so we got old age and technology. I agree. I think with technology, we don't have to move as much because we have so much at our fingertips. So we don't got to get up and go do something or go. Even we don't have to get up and go get the phone. You know, just that simple act of getting up and going to the home phone. Like, nobody even has a landline. You know? But another reason why I think it's important is we have to be example to our family. So I know it's a men's summit. I know we also have women here. But I know for me, when I was growing up, my dad used to have us going out in the gym and doing jump ropes and jumping over flower pots, like little activities like that. He'd take us to go lift it at Central. But what that did for me was, as a child, seeing my dad do that, it instilled in me the work ethic to make it a habit of my own. You know, so it's very powerful as men in our community to be active and show the young ones how to do it. You know, even though you may not be the best at it, just let him kind of take it on his own as he gets older. Because for me, that's what me and my little brother did too. It was kind of like the same way with my mom. I think the body's meant for movement. To me, I think the less we move, the closer we get to the grave. And, you know, and we all got a designated time where we're gonna stop moving for the rest of our lives. So I say, until then, we need to be moving. So that's another activity. Another way to kind of incorporate, kind of like push yourself a little bit more, you know, work out, buy a pedometer. You know, I know when you see those steps, you kind of be like, I don't got my steps in today. You know, so you might do an extra lap or do a walk around the track. Just different ways to kind of keep yourself actively involved in your health. Some of the benefits. Oh, another reason I think is disconnect your electronics. You know, we just cut off our electronics for a day. You'd be surprised. You know, we have a lot more errands we can get done. You know, because you're not on our phone looking at Facebook or Twitter. You said what? I mean, even for me. I mean, sometimes I wake up and I just kind of like delete my apps off my phone because I realize that I look at it too much. I just look at it just because I'm sitting down or in my car. It's just no need. So, of course, the benefits from it are weight loss. You know, there's nothing wrong with, you know, losing weight. I know a lot of us, we usually have goals of weight loss, and that's one way it can definitely impact it. Another way is a stress reliever. I mean, I think there are a lot of studies done that show that weightlifting or any type of physical exertion can actually help you loosen the tension around your mental as far as the way you're thinking. And, you know, if you're stressed out, you know, you had a tough day, you know, go lift some weights, go walk around the lab, you know, and really get a chance to reflect on it and do those things, and it'll help your quality of life. Stretching. Now this is big, because I remember when I was growing up, you know, my dad, you know, my dad and all the men around me, you know, it was tough, you know. And then I get to college and they tell me to do yoga. And I'm like, but it's good. The thing I like about stretching is it's good if you're active or if you're not. You know, stretching helps prevent a lot of things. in the long run, especially for like the older we get. So as we're not moving more, or as we're, you know, not taking our extra steps or drinking our water, stretching can be one of those things that helps stop us from, you know, hurting our back from trying to do a layup playing with your nephew. You know, like stretch before you get out there, or stretch, you know, at night. Another thing is, like, stretching isn't just for, like, women. I remember I thought that as a kid, but then as I got older and the closer I got to playing professionally, even though I have spent short, I went to a couple of camps, but, I mean, all those guys there will tell you the number one thing you have to do is take care of your body. If you don't take care of your body, you're not going to last. And I think it's like that in football for a short stint in your life, it does the same thing, you know. You gotta get out there. Just form like a 5-10 minute routine of just regular things on YouTube. How you look at these like 5 minute. I go to YouTube for everything. 5 minute stretching routine. You wake up, do that, and get your day going. You also be more active and more energized. As I said before, it prevents is injury prevention. It's also a stress reliever. And improves your range of motion. So now you know you're not stretching. You know, and I sometimes do it too. And you drop something, that groan, that old man groan. I'm 24. But that just helps all that, and just kind of keeps your body alive and functioning, keeping it going. There goes the monster of them all. Ooh. I remember when I was looking this up, I saw that plate and I was like, that might be some Lisa. I was like, boy, it looked good. But that's also one of the things that kind of holds you back. Again, the reason I think food is the biggest issue, because it's also the quickest way you can get results. I mean, you start putting the correct fuel into your body will respond. So you're drinking water, and that's one thing I had to learn through playing sports. When I was playing college, my freshman through junior year, I would fluctuate from 275 to 290 a game. I mean, just up and down, 15 pounds. Just coming up and down, up and down. And I didn't think it was a problem, because I was like, well, as long as I'm balling, I don't care. You know, as far as like how it affected me in the game. But then we had a nutritionist come my senior year, and she really started giving me the education on why that shouldn't happen. Why, because I told my calves my junior year, like why that may have been a reason. It was because my body fat was fluctuating too much. I didn't have a stable routine. And once I got that knowledge, I was like, okay, food. And then once I started eating the right food, my body started changing. I started looking like the way I was supposed to look. As far as an athlete, I started looking like the way I played, you know? So I thought that was kind of like an epiphany to me of like, oh, like I can hit the weights, because it's a hard workout, I hit the weights all the time. But sometimes I wouldn't look the way that I wanted to look. And then I realized it was food, the fuel I was putting to my body wasn't matching up with the work I was doing. And once I put those two things together, I started looking like the way I wanted to. So if you take those things and put it into your body, it's gonna take off. You know, that's pennies in the bank. It's again, that's an investment. When you go to the grocery store and you see that fried chicken, or you know, it's after Sunday and you know you want to go to some Lisa's and you want to go get churches and you want to go to BKFC. Think about the investment. It's the return of the investment. Keep investing into your life so that when by the time you're ready to withdraw, the quality of it was worth it. You know, like you're able to be there to see your grandkids. You know, you're able to see there to see them go play, see a football, baseball game, or whatever it will be in the next 20 years. You know, some of the benefits of it. Oh, and again, start the habits for your family. And this is something my mom really kind of instilled in us. My mom was a super healthy eater. I mean, my mom eats so healthy and she still looks young. To where when we go out, people think I'm her husband. It happens to me all the time. I'm not, you know, so it makes her seem young, makes me old. But she was real big on eating. And I know for me, and then once you put it together, like with the education that I received from college, you gotta put that time in to fix it, to cook it. A lot of times you wanna go get quick things, fast food. Well, if you cook it, a lot of times it'll be a lot healthier. You know, if you make yourself cook the bad foods, I bet you won't eat as much. You know, as far as those bad things. It improves your mood, it combats diseases. You know, the healthier you eat, the healthier you are. So now you get your immunity is built up, everything is functioning better. So we put all those things together, it just incorporates a different aspect of your life. So like different changes you can do. Like you see, we got the fried chicken right here, we got the macaroni cheese, the collard greens, and the fried oats. That's a lot. But you look down here and we see now we have baked chicken. We have a little, you know, we still, you know, like the mashed potatoes. We still have the collard greens, which is not as much. And you have the cornbread that is in a muffin size. Like, so it's, again, it's kind of like about that moderation. Like you can still do it, just have a little bit of moderation with it. And it'll be a lot, you know, it's pennies in the bank for the long run, as far as like compounding. As far as screenings, this is something that I know, again, I'm a hard one. We don't do enough of it. Because if we're eating like that, the way that top plate was made, we have to go get these screenings. We have to go get our blood pressure checked. Because if we eating that much sodium and collard greens and macaroni, I mean, it's gonna build up. You gotta, you know, it's like egg, no one puts people's through. That's just how it is. Diabetes screening. I think at the age of 45, you have to, you know, they would prefer that you get them 3 years, like every 3 years. So you get checked every 3 years for diabetes and just try to see where you at, because you want to catch it on the front end. That way you can do the right measures for it. Then on the back end, because when you're on the back end, it's kind of too late. You're trying to play catch up. Prostate cancer screenings. When I was looking at this, it was, you know, alarming, the kind of numbers that we have as African-American males, as far as how much we struggle with this. You know, we don't get checked enough for this. So if you haven't got it, you need to get it, as far as, you know, prostate cancer screenings. And this is just one of my things I was thinking. I was like, when I was in college, I put this together. I said, don't do diets, do a lifestyle. Diets are good for the initial, you know, kind of to get the ball rolling down the hill. But after that, you can do a diet, and let's say you get to your goal. You look like the way you want to look for 3 months, and then you go back, and then you start wondering why you're going back downhill looking like the way you did before. Instead, just impart little lifestyle changes, and then you'll see that return over a longer time, right? I think it'd be good if you did a diet and got you to where you wanted to be, and then you stuck with different things that you liked with that diet, and then just kind of keep doing little things there and little things here. Because if you're not, and you just completely cold stop because you reached your goals, you're just gonna go back to what happened, and it's gonna be a lot harder to start up that next time than it would be if you just kept going. And I think with this, a lot of times, you know, even with me, it's like you mess up, you know, your diet or your routine, and then you think you gotta go all the way back to square one. And it's like, well, all right, well, I ate that donut, I'm done for the week. You know, I'm eating bad for the rest of the week. I'll start back on Monday. And then you get to Monday don't happen. And then you get to a month, and you're like, man, what happened? You know, I need to get back on. But to me, that's why I say, once it becomes a lifestyle, it becomes a conscious thought in your brain. So as you're eating that thing, you're like, oh, okay, I'll eat this donut, but I'm gonna have to get back on it like next meal, right? Instead of going all the way back. My next thing, it's like my final thing. I got this from my friend Isaac Bennett. I know you might know him, he's the athletic director for Crossover Sports. He also played with me at Pittsburgh. Not played with me at Pittsburgh. He wouldn't play at Pittsburgh. He played with me at Booker T. He was my classmate. And he has a saying, it's called Bro David. And I remember we were sitting down. I was there when we met up. Oh, He was sitting there, he's like, man, I want something to, you know, that resonates and does all this. And he just said it like real daily, and I was like, ooh, that's nice. The reason I liked it, the reason I kind of stuck with it is because it really covers all facets of the game as far as the game of life. You know, grow daily, you know, when you wake up in the morning, like, you may not include all of these things into your day, but grow in one area. You know, you may not go out and do that walk, but you may drink four more glasses of water that day. That's still growth. It's not a step back. As you keep going, you just gotta keep growing each and every day in your in every facet, as far as spiritually, mentally, physically. You just gotta keep on going. And with this, it's kind of like something that I really resonate with, just because when you continue to do these things, and as you get older, and I feel like, even though I'm a young guy, I feel like as you get older and you see guys do this thing and continually to be constant in their efforts, it shows up in the long run. You know, just like all those hours I put in, you know, on the field, or, you know, running those extra laps, or all those hours you put in your job that got you to where you are today. I mean, those are those hours that are put in. Put into the most valuable thing you have, which is your life. So you can have a better quality of spending it while you're here. And then also pass that knowledge down to your community and your kids. So now we can keep elevating our community and have a healthier, and move towards a healthier community. And thank you.